Hi, in this video, we will discuss Internet of Things. In your day-to-day life, you use your phone to chat and to send pictures to your friends. That happens over the Internet, right? But that's for people to connect with each other. Now, the Internet of Things or IoT allows all of the things, your clock, light, TV and AC to connect to each other and to you. Imagine your clock notifies your AC, TV and light that it is 10 p.m. and they switch off themselves.
It is 10 p.m. and you must sleep.
It is time for me to be switched off.
Me too should be switched off now.
Me too. Isn't it interesting? But how does IoT work? Well, there are three fundamental components of an IoT system, that is, sensor, software, and internet connection. The sensor is used to detect inputs from the surroundings. The software is used to analyze sensor data and then to follow rules to make decisions about how to respond to data. The internet connection is used to send and receive data and instructions to and from other devices. Let's understand the function of each one by one. Let's take the example of a smart refrigerator to understand them better. A smart refrigerator can send alert to your phone if any item in the fridge is about to expire. Amazing, right? It has a sensor that scans the barcode of any product. Then, its software decodes the scan data and extracts product's expiry date and stores it. And when any product is heading close to its expiry date, it sends an alert to your phone using internet. There are several applications of IoT around us. Let's have a look at few of them. One of the most futuristic applications of IoT is the driverless car. These cars are equipped with sensors and internet and more. The car sends data on traffic, pedestrians, speed breakers, corners and sharp turns and immediately process them. This information is then sent to the controller, which takes corresponding driving actions. As these cars have access to internet, they have the information about live traffic situation using GPS. And in case of heavy traffic in one route, it automatically chooses the other alternate route. Amazon Go, that is, an automated grocery store where no human intervention is required. The store has counters of products arranged like that of a normal supermarket. But when you pick up a product, the sensors immediately add the product to your cart. If you keep the product back, it gets removed. After shopping, when you leave the store, the money is deducted from your Amazon wallet automatically. Isn't that cool? Now, we have store like Amazon Go in India also. A company named Naya Sale Retail Private Limited recently launched a fully autonomous retail store, Water Sale, in Cochin. This is first of this type in India. A smart home is a residence that uses internet-connected devices to enable the remote monitoring and management of appliances and systems such as lighting and heating. Imagine when you wake up and the trigger from alarm clock switches on your kettle so that you can quickly have a fresh cup of tea. Imagine while leaving your home, you get a notification on your phone that refrigerator door is open and lights are on. And you simply switch off the lights and close the refrigerator door using an app on your phone. Or imagine turning on your air conditioner using your phone when you are on the way to home for that perfect room temperature. In a smart home, all these things are possible. That's it in this video. Thank you.